containing the ammunition that are coming off. These boxes would have gone back historically further. We also have tools strapped to the carriage of the gun itself for cleaning and loading. And we have a couple of coverings on the actual cannon barrel itself. Those are designed to prevent any large amounts of moisture, like rain, from getting inside of the barrel. Because if you have a bunch of rain inside and then you put down the powder charge, it's going to turn into a bunch of goop and it's not going to actually fire. So taking these things off, making that gun ready for action. Now with our soldiers just about ready in place, gotta grab five more things from our boxes here. Helpful for us to load and fire the gun. Alright, so now I can command the men to man the piece. So they'll go to their respective spots on the gun. As I mentioned, a well-trained artillery crew should have about 12 men or 15 men, but it's really small here at Mission Mackinac. So you're having to kind of do multiple jobs, but you can still do everything with a smaller crew than a full crew can do. Now the first command in a whole series for actually loading this up is take care, and that is the attention command. 10 pins. So Jim will take his thumb, he'll place that over the touch hole. He's helping to starve this gun of any oxygen. Search piece. Ian takes that corkscrew-like object, that wormer, plunges it down the barrel, twists it around to pull out anything that might be inside. So cleaning this out before we are loading and firing. Pulling out the remains of the previous powder charge, perhaps. You don't want anything smoldering, any kind of smoldering